While dealing with relationship, we made that magical healing of relationship. Then secondly, magical people who made a difference in your life. And now third is forming and continuing the magical relationship. Look, anything you buy, any equipment you buy, there is a list or thing inside, a paper placed inside it of do's and don'ts. That is, if you do what you need to do with that machine, it is gonna work and last for longer time. If you do the don'ts with that particular machine, it is gonna get hampered or not work properly, or may even get damaged permanently. So we human being are the only thing has not come with do's and don'ts. So in a relationship thing, we need to understand every bit of thing by our experience only. So it's said that when a person falls, he learns that there is a stone on that particular road and I need to be very careful, and the second person sitting around just sees that there is a stone on that road, that person fell over that particular road, so when I'll be walking on that particular road, I need to be very careful. So the sitting person is the wiser one. So you can be either the person who learn by falling, or the person who can learn or is wiser enough to learn from the person who has already fallen. So it depends on you. So there are some do's and don'ts of your magical relationship. This very moment in your house or in my house, the things going on are, look, this is wrong in my family, this person is not talking good, this is like this, this is like that, and this all is because of her. Then that her is gonna collect all this garbage thing, this, and then tell that this is all because of him. And then that him person will collect all this garbage and see nobody in the house, now who can I blame? Then he takes all this garbage and says that society hi aisi. So you see, there is a blame game going on everywhere. So first understand things that to change all this relationship, to change this environment, you need to change something in your family, some relation in your family. You need to take responsibility to change these things in your family. So how can you change these things in your family? So you need to change him, you need to change her. No, you need to change yourself. Only if you change a single person, that is yourself, in the family, everything is gonna change. At least for you, it's gonna change. The people around will be cranky, will be arguing, will be critical, they'll be same, but the thing is gonna change is you are gonna change. For instance, a person is bankrupt, he don't have a money at all, and you are going to him and asking him that give me money. So will he able to give you money? And the other point is, you are actually brutal enough to ask him for money, because right now he is bankrupt. In fact, you should help him with some money so that he lives his life better. Similar instance happens for our partners, or whom we are dealing with in our relationship, our grandmother, or say for instance your mother-in-law, father-in-law, etc. These people who are arguing with you day and night are not having peace in their mind or in their heart. So imagine they are not having peace and love in their heart, and you are telling ye mujhse pyar se baat hi nahi karta, ye mujhse hamesha gusse mein hi rehta hai. So you are actually demanding money or demanding love and affection from that person who is not having. So you are actually acting like a brutal person. In fact, you should see what can I give him more so that he can lead a peaceful life. So first thing is, understand the person. So I have previously told you about the priority list of the person. So do it. That is understanding the intellect of the person, that what can be his goals, what are his goals, and accordingly he is gonna act like this, so that it helps you understand that why he is acting like that. Secondly, to understand his emotion, think of the thing he is reacting. So he is not having that thing inside, so he is reacting that ways. And then you need to understand him, you need to keep patience, you need to not expect the things from him, and in fact you need to ask yourself, what can I give to this particular person to have a good relationship? Then Fourth thing is they say avoid clashes and do adjustment everywhere. So you'll say avoid clashes. I am not the one who is fighting. He is the one who is fighting. You'll say I am right every time and he is the person who is wrong. So imagine you are driving on a right way and a van is coming to you with full speed. What you will do? You will stay and say that I am right and he is wrong and you keep on driving. Or what other thing you do is you give way to that particular van to pass by. You'll say some bad words, Hindi bad words you might be knowing, and let the van pass by. And you'll say that okay, then if you can adjust for that particular lorry and abide to traffic rule, just because your intellect is reminding you that your life is at risk, you're not bringing your ego inside that I am right, why should I move, just because your life is at risk. Similarly for your relationship also, your life is at risk in a long term thing. So if you abide to traffic rule, you should also abide to these two rules of ours, that is avoid clashes and adjustment everywhere. Now you will say that I have adjusted this time, next time I am not gonna adjust, or every time why should I adjust. Now think that a second van is coming to you, a third van is coming to you, a fourth van is coming to you, fifth, sixth, seventh, and so on. So what will you do? You are gonna dash that van. Okay, now two vans I have let them go, now the third van I am not gonna allow it to go. So you are gonna dash it and you are gonna lie with multiple fractures in the hospital and say to everyone that look, I was right and that van wala was very wrong. What is gonna matter the thing which is mattering you today is your life. That is important. To live a happy life, you have to do this thing, avoid clashes and adjustment everywhere.